10. And Ohams retrieves. Good hands by Flowers. Shot clock's at 15. Quisenberry off the pump fake. Nicely done by Darius Quisenberry. His first points, Fordham within three.
Yeah, great patience there with the shot fake, getting to his spot, stops, pops the floater, and gets it to go.
So no Nowitzki for Fordham. Josh Colon Navarro might not be available for this one, although he is on the bench in uniform, as is Patrick Kelly. If he gets in, it would be his season debut, a wrist injury late in the preseason has kept him off the court. Quisenberry misses the three. And I believe that Quisenberry was called for a flop going down off the release of the three. The whistle takes us to our first timeout with the Sharks up three early in the Bronx.
Here, our journey is accelerated with this energy overflowing all around us.
Back inside the Rose Hill gym, here's how we went to break. Darius Quisenberry taking a seat there, trying to sell that call. The play's allowed to finish, and then the whistle blows, and that's the signal. It's a flop. It's a warning. And it gives LIU the basketball out of our first media timeout. It's always, I probably am too forgiving, but I meant like a flop used to be a good play.
Yes.
Drawing a foul and selling it, it's a skill. And but we've gone so far in trying to sell things, now we've got to push back and fight back and get away from the unnecessary stuff. But it's not a bad play in its essence, trying to trick the referee into making a call.
No, I agree with you. It's just become disingenuous now. The shooters are manipulating the rule and the officials. We got to rein them back in. Good defense there by Kyle Rose.
Kyle Rose into the game, Antrell Charlton as well. So they don't start this one, but they get in at the first media timeout. And then Rose has that one knocked off his leg out of bounds. Kyle Neptune disagrees. So resetting Fordham's five, it's Day, Rose, Charlton, Cunningham, and Ohams. Wood, Penn, Flowers, Conte, and Rivera still the starting five for LIU. Charlton bothers Penn, so he gives to Conte. Nice little spin to the left hand and then the roll.
And Andrew, not normally is Chuba outweighed in his matchup, but Conte, you can see he is built like a brick house and has about at least 20 to 30 pounds on Chuba Ohams.
Ohams down the lane and off the window for two for him.
And that's what Chuba has to do on the other side. You got to make Conte work on the defensive end, try and wear him down so that he isn't as fresh here on this side of the ball.
Here comes Rivera, he's got 1-3 already. Had that one knocked loose and Rose picks up the loose ball. Played ahead for Day, takes on Conte. And off of Flowers' leg, Fordham will keep. And now Derek Kellogg makes his first substitution. Rivera will leave and in comes Kendall Davis, number 4 for the Sharks. Amron Cunningham from distance off the back of the rim. Easy board for Penn. And Wood with some speed the other way for LIU.
That's not Cameron's strength, but we did see him knock down a couple threes against St. John's.
Little indecision there from Trey Wood. Finally shoots and misses. Weak side to Charlton, leaning in to Davis. Nice bounce for Day. Oham's up strong from the right side this time, beating Conte again.
And Conte just doesn't have the lateral quickness when Chuba goes into his post move. He's able to beat him to the spot, and right there beats him for the basket.
Cunningham almost jumped the passing lane. It's still loose on the floor. Penn and Day and Charlton, and the arrow goes to Fordham. Darius Quisenberry comes back in for Fordham. And Jake Cook makes his debut tonight for LIU, replacing Isaac Conte.
And great hands there in the lane by the Fordham Rams. And this is a team in LIU that the Rams can take advantage of. LIU, they turn the ball over 17 times a night. So definitely a team that gets sloppy with the basketball.
Quisenberry back in. Stopped by Wood. Charlton straight on. Overcooked for three. And Fordham jumps in front by two on the Charlton triple.
And Charlton, really the Swiss Army knife of this team, does a little bit of everything, shoots 37% from beyond the arc.
First Fordham lead of the night, and it's gone just like that as Flowers hits his own three.
And Ty Flowers really is the epitome of a stretch four. He can work down low, but what he likes to do is operate on the perimeter.
Tough catch for Rose, couldn't make it. It's Davis looking for help, does it himself, and he gets the two.
And Andrew, so far the Sharks are, they're outplaying the Rams. I mean, you can see it on both ends, just playing harder, playing tougher right now than the Rams. The Rams, they've got to get into a rhythm.
Last time we were in this gym, St. Francis Brooklyn gave Fordham a push for 30 plus minutes. Rams finally pulled away late and won by 20. But that game was a battle for longer than most expected. Oham's again, already up to 8 for Chuba Oham's.
And with his verticality, when he gets up on a hook shot, there's nobody that can block that. So for Chuba, that can be automatic.
Penn a little too strong, got it back, and gets himself to the free throw line. Chuba Oham's back-to-back 20-point games, the first of his career. He's got 8 already, working hard down low, but his Rams down 1 in the Bronx.
Meet Temple, the home gym with a built-in personal trainer. Temple helps you maximize every workout with custom plans and real-time feedback on your form. Powered by 3D Vision, Tempo is the interactive technology that trains you. With thousands of workouts, including strength training, to cardio, yoga, boxing, and more. Get ready to discover what you're truly capable of. Tempo. Find your strength.
When Subway opened, they changed the fast food game. But sometimes you gotta refresh to be fresh. Welcome to the Eat Fresh Refresh, where there's so much new, some say it can't fit in one ad. I say, we're talking a new All-American Club, deli-style oven-roasted turkey, and...
Oh, that's a new steak and cheese.
Oh, yeah, I knew that. That's the one with the new seasoning.
And that was the new MVP Parmesan vinaigrette.
Right, which makes a next-level foot... Hold up, the Subway logo? Wait, I'm out of time.
At Skill, innovation has always powered us. And now Skill runs on advanced lithium battery technology with 5-minute recharging, powering your tools and your tech. Skill, what powers you?
Gifts for elves, check. Code.
Hold your reindeer, Santa. Capital One Shopping instantly searches for available coupon codes and automatically applies them.
Just download it to your computer. It's free.
Oh, oh. Capital One Shopping. What's in your wallet?
Andrew Bogish and Andrew Posadas back with you here at the historic Rose Hill Gym. And Chuba Oham's already 8 points and 3 rebounds. He has been a double-double machine this year, and so far so good through 8+ minutes.
Yeah, perfect from the field right now, and the size of LIU not bothering Chuba Oham's one bit. Again, game high, 8 points, has 3 rebounds and an assist. But the Rams do find themselves down one to the Sharks. But operating like that in the post, you have to think that LIU is going to have to send a second defender, and hopefully that opens up what we've seen from Chuba. He's been such a great facilitator, such a terrific passer. Hopefully that opens up space for other guys to get their shots going, namely Antonio Day Jr. and Darius Quisenberry.
Out of the timeout, free throws for Iral Penn, a fifth-year senior from Brooklyn. Team's leading scorer at 14.4 a night, plus 6 rebounds, 2 assists, plays 32 minutes. And what's different this year for him, because Isaac Conte is now here, there's a little less physical work for Penn. And like Flowers, he's got game out to the three-point arc. And Conte now becomes the linchpin down low, letting those two others roam a little bit more.
Yeah, I mean, ideally, if you have 3 picks like that and you're starting 5, you're thinking that the paint's going to be congested, but you made the right point there. Flowers and Penn, they can stretch the floor and hurt you from the outside, which only helps that inside-out game with Conte in the post.
The pressure defense almost took that one away from Darius Quisenberry. Shot clock at 12, Charlton in the air, no on a 3, and Flowers rebounds. LIU up by 2, a little less than 9 minutes gone by here in the opening half. Andre Washington, a freshman from Staten Island, is in, number 5 for LIU, as Flowers finds himself free and knocks down the 3. And Kyle Neptune saw that one coming, Rose on the other end, has the answer. Kyle Rose hasn't hit a shot in the last 2 games, 0 for 6. But he knocks that one down, and Fordham back within 2. On the previous LIU possession, Rams did not handle it pick and roll well. And their coach saw it, was upset before Flowers got free to knock down that triple.
Yeah, right here, Kyle Rose putting it behind his back and then just stopping, popping, gets it to drop. And how about both of these teams not known as outside three-point shooting squads by nature, but right now LIU shooting it at 57% and the Rams respectively at 50% from downtown.
Yeah, a lot of the advanced offensive numbers do not like either one of these teams. They are not the most efficient units, but they're getting it done here in the first half of this first half. Charlton looking for some space, nice crossover. Little pull-up is off the window only. LI line ending. They feed Conte down low because he had the smaller Kyle Rose. Nobody could find him.
Yeah, and Andrew right there. Andrew Charlton talking to the official and saying, hey, call it down there. If you're going to call fouls here, call it down there. But for Charlton, that's a tough matchup on the switch, having to deal with Flowers. I mean, with his length, I mean, it's going to be tough for some of these perimeter defenders off switches to have to deal with Ty Flowers.
High screen for Washington. Gets to the foul line. Off back rim, and Simbilla brings it down for Fordham. LIU is led almost wire to wire Day to the free throw line. That's his game. He is as good as anybody at getting in the lane to the rim and either finishing or getting free throws.
Yeah, going downhill, that's his game, and getting to the charity stripe, that's what his specialty is right here, just going right down the lane, and Ty Flowers has no choice but to foul him on the double clutch layup.
Antonio Day, 71 free throw attempts started tonight. That is number 1 in the Atlantic 10 by 20.
When, as a smaller guard too, it's tough. I mean, you have to go down there with the trees every single time. But credit to ADJ, shows no fear, loves to play around the rim and in the painted area, and the referees have rewarded him so far this season.
Ram shows some pressure off the 2 made free throws. LIU gets across, no trouble. little more than halfway through this first half in the Bronx. Andrew Bogish and Andrew Posadas with you from the historic Rose Hill Gym, Frank McLaughlin Family Court down below us. And this is against the Sharks. It is on Keon Burns, who just came in, set the moving screen for Conte, the foul line. So an empty trip for the Sharks and a chance for Fordham to lead for a second time tonight. Charlton curls to the wing and has his second triple of the night.
And right there, the lax help defense, guys having to come in to collapse, leaves Antro Charlton wide open for the three.
Nice crossover by Washington. Rose recovers defensively. Open on the wing, missing the three as Davis. Conte a push off down low, and will walk the other way.
And for Conte there, just trying to battle for position, but pushes Simbilla right in the back. And right now, as we hear on the previous possession, great job by Dave finding a wide open Charlton. And how about the Rams from three, 4 of 7 here in this first half, the three ball working to their advantage.
Shuba Ohams is back in for Fordham, and for the first time as a Ram, Pat Kelly's on the floor, 23 in white. A wrist injury has kept him off the floor, right into the game and shooting off from downtown. That's what they want from Kelly, a good spot-up shooter, one of three players that transferred to Fordham from Penn State a year ago. Simbilla's the other as Ohams rejects Penn. Conte tries a three.
Yeah, and Pat Kelly, one of the three Penn State transfers, and Kyle Neptune hoping that he can kind of evolve and take over in that stretch four role.
Quisenberry drove, no hoop, no whistle. Sharks go the other way. Those three Penn State transfers, though, are now down to two because DJ Gordon has left the Fordham program the last couple of days. Conte on the offensive glass, a reset. In the corner, Washington. Tip back to Conte, another chance. And this time they get the points with the friendly rim.
And just working hard, getting those extra second possessions and able to cash in on second chance points.
Next whistle, a timeout in the Bronx. Charlton spins free to the left hand. And we have now our first flop warning against the Sharks. Three media timeouts, two of them triggered by flop warnings. We're off and running. And Fordham's up by three on LIU.
Here. Our journey is accelerated with this energy overflowing all around us. We are wide awake with a constant urge to engage a restless city. To step outside and walk 8 million paths where one moment can transform everything. That's why we choose Fordham. Thank you.
entertaining as we are here on TV, basketball is better in person. And there is a holiday ticket special, buy two, get one here for Fordham men's and women's basketball. As you can see, use code B2GTF at checkout. Head to FordhamSports.com/tickets or call 718-817-4759. But for now, thanks for being with us. Andrew Bogish and Andrew Posadas with you from the Rose Hill Gym. A little more than 12 minutes into this one, and Fordham with a three-point lead. LIU's got the basketball looking for their second win of the season. One home game, six road games. They beat Delaware State in Brooklyn, and other than that, all on those road games, they have come up short. Kante comes free down low for an easy two.
Just some miscommunication there between Chuba Ohams and Pat Kelly on the rotation and the switch, and Conti gets an open look at the basket. But after a strong start for the Sharks, the Rams just finished a 10-2 run to retake the lead.
Kelly tries another three. This one is short. Run down by Ohams. Shot clock at 15 for Antonio Day Jr. Charlton's got two from downtown. And a good rebound by Rivera. Here's Trey Wood back into the game for the Sharks. Trailing Penn. Thumps iron. Recovered, though, by Davis. Now it's Wood. A little fall away, and that's good for Trey Wood over Darius Quisenberry.
Great ball movement there, and Trey Wood gets to his spot. That little mid-range baseline jump shot, and the Sharks now back up by one. A back-and-forth affair here in the first half.
Davis almost jumped the pass to Charlton. And Trell low. Now it's Ohams. Eight to shoot. Chew him. Figures plus five boards. And those are moves that he didn't always have. He is a far more polished post player in his last two seasons than in his first couple. Contact down low between Penn and Kelly along the baseline, but no foul, just the ball out of bounds to Fordham. Here's Ohams again.
And this is what you like to see, Andrew, against the bigger Conti. Ohams not backing down, getting to his spot, and then from there using that hook shot to perfection. And again, that battle of the bigs all night, the front court of the Rams versus the front court of the Sharks.
The Rams' next game is on Sunday morning. Oham to the other side, and he finally misses for the first time in six attempts. That game on Sunday against Miami. Here's Penn! Ohams from behind. Didn't get the hoop on one end, prevents the hoop on this one.
A great recovery there by Chuba Ohams. Penn thinks he has a easy lay-in, but Chuba Ohams tells him, you'll get nothing and like it.
I've been trying to tell you that I spoke to Miami head coach Jim Larrañaga this morning ahead of that Sunday broadcast. Conte, little oomph. Ohams goes down, and Conte gets the two. And Coach L, super impressed with the start to the season from Chuba Ohams. Mentioned the 20-point, 22-rebound game he had. Said that's just insane. So they, the Hurricanes, who beat Lipscomb last night and are prepping now for Fordham, ready for Ohams. Are they ready for that? In and out and out. Chuba takes, it used to be one of those per game. Now I think it's one every other game. A heat check from downtown. That one did everything but go in. Sharks get two on this end, and they're up by three.
Yeah, and seeing it from Chuba Ohams, his evolution, what he's been able to do to really deepen his bag and have different moves on all three levels, it really is amazing.
Day, the take through contact, and again around the rim and off, and now a block by Conte.
And Andrew, there might be some olive oil on this left rim right here. It really looks like a carnival rim for the Rams these last few possessions.
Skip pass, Rivera. Simbilla flies in for the board. Rams down three, under four to go. Quisenberry. Rose decides not to shoot the three. Shot clock at 10. Shot clock at five. Day looking for space, has to force. And it's a shot clock violation, nicely done by the Sharks. Some defense to stay in front, getting late first half. LIU lead.
Can I get a hamburger?
Nugget time.
Small fries and a vanilla shake.
And one Big Mac. Thanks.
You've been loyal. We want to reward that. Introducing My McDonald's Rewards. Now every order earns points redeemable for free McDonald's.
Vivid Seats, your ticket to soul-raising, heart-racing, 100 beats per minute. What are we wearing? Once-in-a-lifetime memories in the making, bumps like a goose brisket for tailgating, reach for the universe, rapid breathing, can't catch my breath, top of lung singing. This is it. The moment is now. Can you believe it? Wow. Get your tickets at Vivid Seats. Life happens live.
This is your home. This is your family room, slash gym. The guest bedroom, slash music studio. The day bed, slash dog bed. The living room, slash yoga shanti, slash regional office.
How did you guys do it?
Slash classroom. And this is the basement, slash panic room. Maybe what your family needs is a vacation home, slash vacation home. Find yours on the Vrbo app.
Penguins Capitals, tomorrow on ESPN Plus.
Offense, rebounding, and defense from Chuba Ohams. His great start to the season continuing tonight. He's got two blocks, plus 10 rebounds, plus 10 points, five rebounds, and an assist. And we've been in the gym for all of their home games this year, so it sounds repetitive, but if you haven't, if you've been watching, it's obvious. But if you haven't, this is a young man that has overcome two major injuries. And when he got here to Fordham, was pure athlete and won most of his battles based on that. But he's put in a lot of work to become a better basketball player.
I mean, you're seeing all facets of his game blossom, from the post work that he does to being able to be a rim protector at the five spot, and then being a passer, being able to initiate offense and find guys out of double teams. I mean, Chuba Ohams, his repertoire has grown immensely since he arrived on campus 5 years ago now.
Getting late opening half here in the Bronx. The Sharks with the lead and the basketball. Isaac Conte's having a good first half down low as well. But nowhere near Ohams. Uncontested rebound for Chuba. LIU has led for most of this first half. A couple of brief leads for the home team.
Darius Quisenberry has been quiet, just one of three from the floor. Really been conservative here in the first half.
Rose, foul line jumpers off back rim, tipped up by Charlton. And that's last touch by Ohams. Well, we've certainly learned about Darius Quisenberry in his first month plus on the court for Fordham. He's a streaky scorer. We've seen him have 20-point halves, and then we've seen him have 2-point halves. So at the end of the day, it looks like a good game, but maybe you want a little more consistency over a full 40.
Yeah, certainly someone who's hit or miss, and if he does get going from beyond the arc, it is something to watch.
Here's Penn on a dive and a give, but first a travel from Conte.
And Conte had the position he wanted to get that lay and just shuffles his feet in the paint. And now for both teams, LIU going on a scoreless drought of over 2 minutes, and for the Rams, their drought is getting near to 4 minutes now.
Back door, lob, Ohams drops it in. They ran that play three times for dunks last week here against St. Francis Brooklyn, their first attempt. It's a lay-in, but they'll take the 2 points anyway.
Yeah, Chuba really lulls you to sleep, looking like he's going to set that pick, and then at the elbow, cutting back and slipping for the alley-oop.
Flowers to the wing. That's a sweet lefty stroke. Nice outlet by Charlton for Day. He was one on two, though. Waits for some help. It's Rose. Quick to the rim, and the reverse falls in.
And that's a much-needed sight. Kyle Rose hasn't really been able to get it going offensively after that career night against St. Thomas, so that's something that Kyle Neptune has to be happy to see.
Penn throws it away under duress. Ohams almost gave it right back. Nice look cross-court. Quisenberry's three on the other end. The give from Rose, the hit from Quisenberry. Seven in a row for Fordham. They lead by four. Derek Kellogg is angry on the LIU sideline. It's a great look by Rose. And maybe more importantly, Quisenberry finds the stroke from deep.
Yeah, we're talking about Darius Quisenberry getting going. And right there, Kyle Rose, a great cross-court pass. And again, that's multiple times that we've seen LIU not play good enough help defense to at least get a contest out there. The Rams are getting wide open three-point looks from the wing, and they've been able to take advantage. 5 of 13, 39% from beyond the arc for Fordham.
Trying to decide if Derek Kellogg was complaining about Penn, the contact against him down on the offensive end, which led to the errant pass, which sprung Fordham, or maybe Ohams possibly walking near half court as that fast break began. Either way, coach had his say and actually continues to have a few words working that far sideline. He has been in this building for multiple schools, former head coach at UMass. Now in charge of first the Blackbirds and now the Sharks of just LIU, dropping Brooklyn from their name. Another throwaway. Penn went down. It looked like he got yanked down, but I don't know that that pass was going to find him if he kept his feet either.
Yeah, that looked like that pass was way far to the right, but Quisenberry does get away knowing that he is smaller than Penn, kind of shoves him down a bit and uses some of that strength, but again, the call, it isn't called, and down the stretch, the Rams have really asserted themselves and been more physical, and it's a reason why they now have the lead.
How about Day, the sprint? Full 94 on like three dribbles. Antonio Day Jr. in a hurry.
ADJ goes coast to coast on the layup.
Fordham by six all of a sudden. Final half minute of the first half. Davis, baseline. Penn able to catch this time and score and flex.
And E-Route Penn, I mean, he's been able to work right now in this first half, now into double figures with 10 points.
Rams will use their timeout before half possession, 12.9 on the clock. Still some conversation from the LIU sideline about recent officiating. It's a 4-point Fordham lead in a back and forth first half. That 6-point edge a second ago was the largest lead for Fordham in this first half. And this is a fairly significant final 13 seconds here in a first half where LIU, for the most part, played from in front. They certainly wouldn't mind at least a defensive stand, if not turning that into some points before halftime. They feel just a little bit better about their opening 20 minutes.
Yeah, after that quick start that they had, I mean, they had an 8-point lead early on against the Rams, but as the first half progressed, the Rams started getting comfortable on both ends. And now if you're LIU, having lost that momentum, as long as you can keep this a 4-point game, you got to think that Derek Kellogg, with everything that's happening, officiating and all that on both ends, you got to think he'll be happy with that. But you got to imagine that he is frustrated and flustered with how the last 3 or 4 minutes have gone for his team.
Rose will inbound from the end of the Sharks bench. Davis, a good defender on Day, and gives the foul with 7 seconds now to go before halftime. Fifth team foul on LIU. Washington replaces Davis.
And Andrew, by giving that foul, at least LIU can now see what Fordham's in, what they're trying to run, and now they can go and attack it again this second time.
Into Quisenberry this time, goes right down the side of the lane, the second effort's through. The final hoop of the first half goes to the Rams. And it sends them off the floor, up by six after an early eight-point hole. Quisenberry the take, the miss, the gather, and the score for the mini exclamation point to end our first 20 here in the Bronx.
Meet Temple, the home gym with a built-in personal trainer. Maximize every workout with custom plans and real-time feedback on your form. Powered by 3D Vision, Tempo is the interactive technology that trains you. With thousands of workouts, including strength training, to cardio, yoga, boxing, and more. Get ready to discover what you're truly capable of. Tempo. Find your strength.
Stop dreaming. With Rocket Mortgage, you can use your home's equity and make that renovation a reality.
When you're ready to turn your home into your dream home, Rocket can.
Rocket.
When we give from our hearts, it unwraps how we feel. All that they imagine is suddenly real. They believe in their magic to build bigger things. Soar to new places as an adventure begins. Because a gift has the power to take them further than before. What we value most shouldn't cost more.
Get cheesy at Red Robin with our new cheesy bacon fondue. Some dip, some dunk, some douse. Dive in before it disappears.
Red Robin.
Yum.
Walking on ice on me.
This holiday, let them shine like never before. This is how we shine. Find the perfect gift at Zales, the Diamond Store.
It's the most joyous time of the year.
Especially at T-Mobile.
Let's go to Diane.
Can you tell us what's happening?
Yeah, I got the awesome new iPhone 13 Pro and AirPods, and T-Mobile's paying for them both. Oh, and I get a free year of Apple TV Plus.
Ah! And this is for new and existing T-Mobile and Sprint customers.
Like me.
Back to you.
Hello.
Hello?
We're going to T-Mobile.
Upgrade to the iPhone 13 Pro and AirPods, both on us, only at T-Mobile.
Welcome back inside the Roseville Gym. Andrew Ryan Bogish, Andrew Brian Posadas with you on this Thursday night. Thanks so much for being with us. A roller coaster back and forth first half ends with Fordham up 39-33 on LIU. Certainly not the pretty start Fordham wanted, but a better finish, and then the flip for LIU. They were better in the first 10 minutes or so of this half.
Yeah, the Sharks got to biting early on, got off to a 10-2 lead. But as the first half continued, the Rams really settled in, got comfortable, and then used a 10-2 run of their own down the stretch there, and now see themselves with a six-point lead following a game higher. As we see, both teams shooting the ball well, 45% for the Sharks, 49% for Fordham, and it really has been a battle of the boards. We talked about both front courts, and right now the Sharks hold the advantage rebounding the ball, but those nine turnovers, very crucial. The Rams have been able to turn that into 13 points off of those nine turnovers, and they see themselves with a six-point lead at half.
Looking to get their seventh win of the season and bounce back from Sunday's loss at St. John's. LIU, meanwhile, in pursuit of its second victory this year. It would be their first in several. When we come back, a chat with Fordham's brand-new head coach, Kyle Neptune. Your first half highlights as well, all next from the Bronx.
The ancient Greeks had four words for love. The most admirable is called agape, love as an action. For 175 years, New York Life has been helping people act on their love. So they can look back or look ahead and say, we got it right. We did good.
At Skill, innovation has always powered us. And now Skill runs on advanced lithium battery technology, delivering longer runtime, maximum power, and 5-minute recharging. Powering your tools and your tech. Skill, the tools to do the job, the technology to do it better.
Hi, my name is Jasmine, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Grilled Chicken Club is the wonderfully marinated and juicy chicken breast. The marinade actually reminds me of my mother's cooking. You know, marinades, usually they take time, and you can tell that it was put together with love.
My name is Meredith, and a little thing I love about Chick-fil-A's mac and cheese is the oven-toasted, cheesy top layer. If home had a flavor, it would be Chick-fil-A's mac and cheese. I'm passionate about it.
This is your home. This is your family room, slash gym. The guest bedroom, slash music studio. The day bed, slash dog bed. The living room, slash yoga shanty, slash regional office.
How did you guys do it?
Slash classroom. And this is the basement, slash panic room. Maybe what your family needs is a vacation home, slash vacation home. Find yours on the Vrbo app.
Away. She want me now, but I'm making her wait. I'm at the table, a thousand a plate.
With 5 seconds left for the win, it's gone! It's gone!
Said what I said, and I'm standing on top of it.
Let's go.
Staring at fate, I'm in the lead, and I'm breaking away. If you're not working, you're taking no space. I'm at the table, a thousand a plate.
Luck of the Irish. Luck of the Irish. Mama's about to get herself a little Luck of the Irish.
It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. Wednesdays on FXX. Now streaming FX on Hulu.
A mountain of toys to fulfill many wishes must be carried across all roads and all bridges.
It's not magic that makes more holiday deliveries to homes in the U.S. than anyone else. It's the hardworking people of the United States Postal Service.
Kyle Neptune is 10.5 games into his tenure as Fordham's head coach. A good time to check in on how things are going. Here is coach with WFUV Radio's Nick DeLuca.
First-year Fordham head coach Kyle Neptune, Nick DeLuca here with you. Coach, thanks for taking some time. Good to be with you today.
Oh, thanks for having me. It's great.
10 games into the season for you guys at 6-4. A lot of new in the Rose Hill gym, 9 new players onto your roster. How would you evaluate where the team is right now?
You know what? For like you mentioned, for having a bunch of new guys, all new coaches, starting this program from scratch, I think we're in an unbelievable spot. And we're really not looking at our record. It's just kind of where we are, just in terms of our principles and what we're looking to do offensively and defensively. I think we're doing adequate right now. And
part of the newness on the roster, of course, you. This is your first opportunity to be a head coach coming from Villanova as an assistant. How has that transition gone for you? What are some of the things that you feel like have been good and gone well, and other things that you feel like are interesting and things you're trying to focus on as you work your way into becoming a head coach?
I think the one thing that, I'll use the word I think the one thing that I did was hire an unbelievable staff. And I think our guys are really carrying us right now. From top to bottom, they just really work so hard and make my job very, very easy. And I would say the thing that you really can't prepare for is the unexpected. And, just different things happening throughout the day that you don't think about, and everything requires your attention. So I use those two things.
You mentioned upon getting on campus that you're emphasizing the defensive end of the floor, the effort and the attitude of the team. You want to be a really gritty team and play harder than your opponents. How do you feel that has fared for your team, and what are some of the areas that stick out for you guys to improve as conference play is right around the corner?
I don't know if any coach ever in the country is like, oh, we're perfect, we're 100% where we want to be. I don't think it's ever happened. But for our team, I think we're in a good spot. I think our guys understand what we're looking to do. I think our guys go into the game trying to execute the game plan. And that's all we could ask them at this point in the year. And I think as the year goes, we'll continue to get better.
You've gotten great contributions from a couple of transfer guards on the team so far. Darius Quisenberry from Youngstown State, Antonio Day from FIU. Those two guys in the backcourt have really led things offensively and been so key in the six wins that you guys have gotten. What have they meant, and what has been the key contributing factor in allowing them to step onto campus and be so successful so early?
Well, I think the unique thing about our team, you mentioned we got a lot of new guys, but this is the kind of the first time in NCAA history that when you have a lot of new guys, if they're from the transfer portal, they could play right away. So, you know, yeah, Darius has been, you know, entire life, his entire career in college. Antonio has been doing well his entire life, his entire career in college. And then not to mention, we have Chuba, who's an older guy. And we got Josh Navarro, an older guy. And, you know, most of our roster is built with older guys who've been there, done that in college. So, yeah, it's new and fresh in terms of what we're looking to do, but they don't have the same learning curve a usual team would have.
I know you mentioned Chuba Ohams, and you've been really impressed with him. The first 2020 performance by a Fordham player since 2000, a couple of games back. What has made him so effective early on, and what are some of the things that you feel like makes him a leader on the team?
You know, I think that his just mentality. I think that he's come in with a great mentality, and, you know, the guys love him. And he just comes and, you know, fights every day. And I think that's what's allowed him to kind of flourish so far. He's just outworking people.
Coach, you wrap up the non-conference schedule, LIU Brooklyn tomorrow night. You've got Miami right around the corner against in Barclays Center, rather, and then finish out the non-conference against Georgia Southern. What are some of the things that you're looking to continue to improve? What are some of those areas that you want to tighten up as you head into the conference play on the other side of Christmas break?
Everything. Literally everything. And again, I think it's kind of coach speak, but, you know, it's true. Like, we're never going to be satisfied. We want to continue to get better throughout the year, and we want to be playing our best basketball at the end of the season. So I think for us, we talked about our defense earlier. I think that's always going to be something that we're looking to make our staple. We want to continue to kind of clean things up on that end. And then offensively, we definitely have a bunch of things we can clean up as well, our turnovers and just some cohesion things offensively. So to answer your question, everything.
At BK, the Italian original chicken is back and in the 2 for $6, thanks to Pete Neubacher. Crispy chicken, marinara sauce, and melty mozzarella, because of him. For Pete's sake, the Italian original chicken sandwich is back in the 2 for $6. Pete's way, way better.
This season, don't be intimidated by winter. Be inspired by it. Take the cold head on in one of Kia's undeniably capable SUVs or sporty sedans from the brand ranked number one in dependability by J.D. Power. We've got new vehicles arriving weekly, so take the one home that's right for you. Command the season in one of our reliable cold conquering models. Get 1.9% APR for up to 60 months on the purchase of select models.
Looks like Daryl's still looking for that money in his home.
Should we tell him he can just refinance with Rocket Mortgage?
Nah, let's see where this goes.
When you want to find money in your home, Rocket can.
Sorry.
Rocket.
What makes my neighborhood great? The folk, the people, always finding a way. There's a lot of talent in these streets, all grinding for an opportunity. The court is where we push each other to grow, where lessons are taught. Because when we lift each other up here, we all get better everywhere.
And that's how you change the game for good.
I set that screen. Here we go.
Corinne Marie, I got you some stuff for your new laptop. Power station, dongle, and a hotspot.
Dad, why?
Because I know about technology stuff.
Okay, well, have you ever heard of Wi-Fi 6, touchscreen, super long-lasting battery life? Because this has all of that.
But I knew, you know what? I knew that. Actually, this is stuff for my laptop.
Mm-hmm.
I was just quizzing you.
Okay.
You passed, by the way.
Want a laptop that has it all? That's Intel Evo.
What is your name?
Stanton Carlisle.
Can you read minds?
Yes, I can.
If you displease the right people, the world closes in on you very fast.
Nightmare Alley. Rated R. Only in theaters December 17th.
We'll be right back.
the greatest woman of all time.
Welcome back to the historic Rose Hill Gym. 20 minutes in the books. Let's look at some first half action, shall we? And the Sharks really got off to an auspicious start, but the Rams battled back. Kyle Rose right there putting it behind his back, knocking down the tray from the wing. And then Antrell Charlton going spin cycle and getting the nice lefty lay-in to go. And right here, that alley-oop, that Charlton to Chuba connection works. And the Rams use a strong end to that first half to get this six-point lead at the break.
That's Andrew Posadas. I'm Andrew Bogish. Thanks again for being with us here at the historic Rose Hill Gym on this Thursday night. Here we go with half number two. Fordham up by six on LIU. Isaac Conte contorting, missing, but will get free throws. The LIU big 5 of 6 in that first half for 10 points. He and Penn with a team-high 10. Chuba Oham's a game-high 12 plus 6 rebounds for Fordham. Chuba more than halfway to what would be a 7th double-double in game 11 as Conte gets the free throw.
And it really has been a battle of the bigs, and Isaac Conte and Chuba Oham's, and both teams really getting their work done in the paint. The Sharks with 18 and the Rams with 20, both teams with more than half of their points in the painted area.
And LIU with some pressure to open the second half. Rams have returned to their starting five, which includes Harrison and Cimbilla, making a rare start in place of Charlton and Rose. And those two again begin the half on the bench. Quisenberry working with Cimbilla, but good D by Rivera. Now a touch low for Cimbilla with 8 to shoot. Harrison off one dribble into the hands of Rivera.
And right there, Cimbilla gets positioning on the post, but just unable to back down Conte.
It's Penn on the right. He's got 2, 12 in the game, and the Sharks within 2.
Yeah, 24 points combined from Penn and Conte so far for the Sharks.
Conte snuck baseline, missed the takeaway. Nice give by Oham's, but no finish by Cimbilla.
And Kyle Neptune jumping up on the sideline. He is unhappy, thought there was a foul call there.
Here's Penn with position again. Cimbilla the throwaway. Oham's for Cimbilla. Bumping with Conte. The left hand's too strong. Second chance is good.
And we talk about raw ability. Cimbilla has that. You can see the athleticism. Just got to put it together and continue polishing his game.
Conte goes to work and scores. How about this? Dueling bigs at a halftime.
It's been Chuba Oham's versus Isaac Conte, and neither of them have blinked.
Day bumping with Flowers, had it knocked away. Oham's low to corral it and call for time. He had teammates to pass it and save the timeout, but he burns the TO in the first 2+ of the second half. Fordham by 2 at the Rose Hill Gym.
Here, our journey is accelerated with this energy overflowing all around us. We are wide awake with a constant urge to engage a restless city. To step outside and walk 8 million paths, where one moment can transform everything. That's why we choose Fordham.
Thank you.
the value of money, the promise it holds, the good it can do, the security it can provide. At Ridgewood, we want to help you to continue to learn with short online courses covering key financial skills.
The course about how to retire early.
Total winner. Wow.
Check out our free courses at ridgewoodbank.com.
We're back here in the Rose Hill Gym. Happy to be on SNY tonight, this afternoon on SNY. You watch the Fordham women with a dramatic win over Manhattan last night. Caitlin Downey, Meg Jonathan, the top left of your screen there. Matilda Flood in front of them. Adonna Tacky as well. Not pictured is the two heroines of last night. Sarah Carpell, a steal that led to Kendall Jeremiah's lay-in with 6/10 of a second left for the Rams to sneak past Manhattan in a game they very easily could have lost, but found a way not to lose it at the very last moment.
Andrew, we had great seats. The Battle of the Bronx didn't disappoint. I mean, really was just a back and forth, just competitive basketball game. And you mentioned it, Sarah Carpell with the steal on Dede Davis and Kendall Jeremiah with the game-winning lay-in.
And Dede Davis had a great fourth quarter for Manhattan, almost won the game for the Jaspers by herself. Ohams around the paint and in off the window. He was one of the Fordham players here last night, sitting sideline left, that was yapping with D.D. Davis, and she was answering back with words and buckets. And again, almost won the game by herself for the Jaspers, but the strip of her led to Jeremiah's lay-in and the Fordham survival.
And you just love to see the love reciprocated between both the men's and women's team. Both respect each other, and it's good to see both teams showing love at every home game.
Quisenberry, catch and shoot. It's short. Although, the way Davis responded to the playful words from the sideline as Wood explodes for two, maybe they should stay away. Maybe they didn't help the cause last night.
Yeah, Dede Davis is definitely cut from the Kobe Bryant cloth. Use that as motivation. But, I mean, just a great atmosphere last night. Couldn't ask for anything more in a rivalry game.
Quisenberry looking for an opening, can't find one. It's Day instead. A reset three is good from Antonio Day Jr.
That's great off-ball movement there by Antonio Day just to move around and allow Quisenberry to make the pass, and he knocks down yet another open three.
And a good take. It finally falls off the rim, but he was fouled. The call's on Ohams. But the good news for Fordham, that's his first 24 minutes into this game. It leaves Zirau Penn at the free throw line. Penn now 2 of 3 from the stripe tonight. Rose and Charlton get Harrison and Simbilla. Conte sits and Kendall Davis comes back in for LIU. Davis gave them good minutes, especially defensively in the first half.
And Andrew, you made a great point. Just one foul for Chuba Ohams, having to deal with both Penn and Conte in the post. It's just been a great defensive effort by Chuba tonight.
1 of 2 at the line for Penn. So Fordham's up 4 in possession. Day off the pick, the give up, and the Rose 3.
And that's what we've seen. The Rams been able to kick it out and find shooters on the perimeter, and they're making this Sharks defense pay.
Kyle Rose did limited scoring before this year for Fordham. Came in averaging 6 points a game. Rivera's 3 is short. And Quisenberry gets the deflection. Rose has 8 with a couple of triples tonight. Looking for more on the drive and kick. Charlton just missed that one. And Penn clears for the Sharks. Rivera's wide open. Wood finally found him. But Rose got there in time to prevent the 3. So now Flowers with 18 to shoot gives up to Wood. The UMass Lowell transfer. He shoots and misses. Another rebound for Darius Quisenberry.
And after knocking down their first three couple of shots from the perimeter, the Sharks have gone cold from beyond the arc.
And they're down 7, 5 gone by. Quisenberry makes it a 9-point hole.
And a great drive to the basket, using that strength over Rivera and getting the right-handed land.
9 for Quisenberry, 10 for Day, 14 for Ohams. 51 total, and now the knockaway. Numbers here. Quisenberry goes all the way and will shoot free throws. Rams trying to open this one up for the first time tonight. This 9-point edge is their largest, and they've got free throws when we come back.
The only thing better than the free large fries you get when you download the app are the points you'll start earning on any order with new My McDonald's rewards. Download the app today to get free large fries.
Gifts for elves, check. Now just in a dang coupon code.
Hold your reindeer, Santa.
Samuel, what's up?
I got a gift for you. Capital One Shopping instantly searches for available coupon codes and automatically applies them. Just download it to your computer. It's free.
Whoa.
Oh, I have that saved me a bundle.
You have?
Mm-hmm.
What?
So, that get me off your naughty list?
Are you off the naughty words?
Yes.
Oh, oh, oh. I don't think so.
Capital One Shopping. It's kind of genius. What's in your wallet?
Maybe tomorrow I'll run away with you.
Tomorrow? Deal.
What were you doing under there with my sister?
This Friday, the most celebrated story of all time. It's the movie event of the holiday season.
It's just you and me. Forever.
You don't want to start with, I'd like to take you to coffee.
West Side Story, rated PG-13, only in theaters Friday.
Steph Curry is the best basketball player in the world.
Curry, another three. Bang!
We all know how big time Joel Embiid is.
Embiid asks the crowd, let me hear you.
It's Saturday primetime. Warriors, Sixers, Saturday on ABC.
Fordham basketball is very excited about this new partnership with SNY at a big time moment in the gym last night. That's the steal, and then the Jeremiah lay-in with just 0.6 seconds left for the dramatic win over Manhattan. And Fordham hoping to put more moments, more wins on SNY this year. Here's the upcoming schedule as we move towards 2022. Those are all A-10 games. They're all important for both the men's and women's programs. And tonight, Fordham with a 9-point edge. And looking for more with Darius Quisenberry at the free throw line. You and I, in earlier games, have talked about Fordham's struggles in a half-court setting. Those struggles are still there. I think less of a struggle. But certainly this team is still at its best when defense becomes offense and Quisenberry and Day and Charlton are off and running, looking to be athletic in the open floor.
Yeah, and you said it right there. Their defense has been able to force 10 turnovers from the Sharks.